Welcome back to Up With Krem. You know, sometimes the greatest form of competition is the kind that you find with the people closest to you, with stakes that can help everyone succeed and grow and improve. That's what's happening right now for six Spokane breweries competing in their winter edition of the Lester Cup Brew Off. It started with a simple challenge 3 years ago from Mountain Lakes Brewing Company to Black Label Brewing Company.
We like each other and we really want Spokane beer to become a scene. We want people to come to Spokane for beer. And we don't do that by trying to put each other out of business. It's really to try to, you know, play well with each other and have a reason for people to visit all of them.
And soon two breweries grew into six, competing for what would come to be called the Lester Cup.
I was like, yes, this is awesome to have a little competition that people will go to.
We all loved it, thought it'd be fun to, you know, challenge each other and have some fun with it too.
We're here to do something fun and be successful together.
Once in summer and once in the winter, Mountain Lakes and Black Label are now joined by Bellwether Brewing, The Grain Shed, Humble Abode, and the current cup holders, Whistle Punk. The current cup holders pick a style, and all six breweries compete to see who Spokane says brewed the best of the challenge beers. This winter, the challenge beer is pastry stout, which means right now, adventurous beer drinkers in Spokane can find beer flavors like tiramisu and salted caramel.
It started out as just an oatmeal, nice, thick, sweeter stout. We put some cocoa nibs in, and I made a brewer's caramel, and that's where the caramel flavor's coming from, and then we added some pink Himalayan sea salt on top of it.
Cinnamon rolls and panettone.
I haven't brewed a stout since I was home brewing 5, 6, 7 years ago. Our baker, Sean, was like, do panettone. I don't think our beer necessarily tastes like panettone, but it's good. It's really tasty and different.
French toast and carrot cake.
I think beer is a connecting point for people. We're always trying to do something a little bit different using fun ingredients. But yeah, we've never used carrots before in a brew, and so we get all the sugars coming out of it, and it gives it a lot of fun flavor.
All available in a convenient six-pack that can be enjoyed safely at home, an adaptation all six breweries happily made to keep the tradition going during the pandemic.
This has really helped us a lot because, it really, it's the equivalent of a month or two worth of revenue.
All of us need to keep our sanity somehow, you know, and having a little bit of normality that you can take home with you is awesome.
100% we made the right choice to continue doing this. I actually really love having them in cans.
And even though the competition is meant to be supportive, friendly, and fun,
the coolest thing is we won the first one, so that made us want to keep doing it.
There is still plenty of trash talk, a little gloating.
We did just win one. Yeah, we won the Strong Ales.
And of course, the obvious sting of defeat.
Absolutely. Of course I want to win. Yeah, we have not won a category yet. So this is we're still fighting.
We have not won one yet.
We've already had second place.
Yeah, we're going to get there.
But when six local breweries challenge themselves, share their beer safely, and elevate Spokane's entire brewery scene, how could any of us possibly lose? Now, voting for the Winter Lester Cup is running now until February 15th. You can check out their social media pages. But each of the six competing breweries also still have some of their six packs of beer available to purchase right now. And each pack comes with its own voting card, if you want to do such a thing.